Good morning, my rogue readers. My name is Erin Rogoff, and welcome back to my BookTube channel, where books are the topic of discussion all day, every day. And in today's video, I will be discussing Quarantine, The Loners by Lex Thomas. Now, Quarantine, The Loners is a young adult fiction, science fiction, dystopian fiction novel, and it is book one of the Quarantine series. And in that series, we have Quarantine, The Loners, Quarantine the Saints, Quarantine the Burnouts, and Quarantine the Giant. I have all four books in the series. My mom got me the books for Christmas, and I am devouring them like I devour chocolate cake. I am serious. They are so good. I'm going to go in-depth with the summary, but I'm not giving you all the spoilers because I want you to read the book too instead of just watch this video, listen to it, and say, hey, I read the book. So, to begin, David and his girlfriend Hillary go out on a date, but when Hillary gets a more than flirty text from one of David's friends on the football team, his name is Sam, he reads the text and finds out that Hillary and Sam have been hooking up behind his back. They've betrayed his trust, and it is just devastating to David, and he doesn't know how he can win Hillary back. So, David then breaks up with Hillary and then goes to a party where she and Sam will be. Then he beats up Sam while Hillary watches with a smile on her face. She is so cold-hearted, it is not even funny. The summer ends and David goes back to McKinley High School and his little brother Will just starts his high school adventure and it does not turn out the way they had both hoped. An explosion goes off in the science wing of the school and all the teachers die instantly while the teen's hair falls out and grows back white, which the teens later dye to match different social circles. And that gets a little bit confusing on its own because some of the high school cliques are similar. So David tries helping his teacher to safety, but the teacher dies right in front of him by hacking up his own lungs and blood, and there is a lot of bloody stuff in this book, so if you're weak-stomached, then maybe don't read this book, but otherwise read it, because I highly recommend it. So, weeks pass, and David watches over Will. The two are loners and have no clique, so it's much more difficult for them than it would be for those with a clique. And the government contacts the teens and forbids anyone to enter the school or leave the school. Then they board up the windows and seal the doors, and then the government sends out care packages to the teenagers. And besides the care package, the government sends a computer-like device inside the school, which tells the teens that they're infected with something completely fatal to adults, so that's why they're under quarantine. And the computer says that the kids will grow out of the virus once they reach maturity, so the computer will test them for the virus, and if they're not sick, they will be let out. And David and Will make a shelter inside a janitor's closet and do odd jobs for the cliques to survive. And then David meets Lucy, a pretty one, who's been tossed out of her clique because she doesn't want to hook up with Brad. And Hillary, who is the head of the pretty ones, wanted her to do so. David sees one of varsity, Brad, target Lucy, and tries to assault her. So David defends Lucy and accidentally kills Brad. It is not David's fault, technically, because Brad fell back and cracked his skull on the floor. So David can't necessarily be blamed for Brad's death, but he is blamed anyway. Will takes Lucy to his and David's hiding place, but he gets jealous when Lucy likes David more than she likes Will. Will has a so-called master plan to get the girl, so he goes to a friend and trades in his loot for a necklace. I don't know why he decided to do that. He could easily have just told Lucy how he feels, but he thought that this epic gesture would be even more intense for her, I guess? Will gets stuck in the jock's territory, then overhears Sam's plan to get back at David for killing Brad. David is then abducted by varsity and is nearly hanged, and then the loners help David to safety and ask that he be their leader while Will gets jealous. David accepts being the loner's leader and then finds that he has a following. And Varsity attacks the loners' territory by locking them up inside their territory, then say the loners will be dead the next time there's a food drop. The loners are let out, and then David leads the loners to the drop site. Sam has a plan to kill David, but more loners than David ever knew existed come out of hiding and join him. And a bloodbath ensues, but David comes out victorious while Sam winds up bruised and bloody. And instead of David killing Sam, David goes over to Sam and says, "I win." And Hillary smiles, and when I read that part, I was thinking to myself, do not trust her, dude. Seriously, she is just all around cold-hearted, bad, and just such an intensely horrible character. And afterwards, Hillary plans to meet up with Sam in secret, then watches Sam kill one of their own friends. And Hillary does meet up with David, and he finally rejects her after she asks him to kill Sam. Elsewhere, Will professes his love to Lucy, but she thinks of him only as a friend because she's actually in love with David. And then one of the cliques decides to host a party and invites the loners. Then David and Lucy kiss while Will is spying on them, and he gets insanely jealous. So while David goes back to the loners' territory, he's attacked by Varsity and the Pretty Ones and gets stabbed in the eye by Hillary, and then Will runs away and isn't seen for days, or is it weeks, and then returns. David finds out that his nose is bleeding and his sanity is turning iffy, meaning he's healing from the virus. So he has to leave before the other teens become the death of him, and the question is, can he make it out when Sam puts a price on his head? David is helped by most of the loner clique, although some do turn against him because of the bounty, and then David finds a tunnel out of the school, and so we are left wondering, is it really a way out, or is it just another dead end? And I am going to stop the summary here because I want you to read the book too. As far as the character analyses go, David Thorpe is the protagonist of Quarantine the Loners. He is protective of Will, even when Will doesn't appreciate and or want to be protected, and then he dumped Hillary when he found out that she was cheating on him. That was a good move. And David is the loner type, someone who seems really cool to me, but that's just me. Will is David's younger brother. He's a freshman, about 15 years old. Will has epilepsy, and he hasn't been taking his medication since the quarantine in their school began. He is described as good-looking and flirtatious with girls who have what he wants. And then Hillary, she is David's ex-girlfriend. She cheated on David with one of his friends on the football team. She is selfish, cold-hearted, and shaved a loner girl's hair to humiliate her. And she makes it clear that she doesn't want to be with a loser. Her words, not mine. She's messed up and just such an awful character. I have to give it to Lex Thomas for writing such an evil character because you just love to hate her. Moving on to Lucy. She is David's love interest and partially Will's love interest because there is a love triangle here. She is a former pretty one who is now a current loner and was nearly attacked by Brad, but David accidentally killed him to save her. And she went to summer camp called Wild Trek with Will. And she loves David, but she's only a friend of Will's, even though he wishes that there was something more between them. What did I like about the book? There is so much, I am telling you. The Quarantine series reminds me a bit of the Gone series by Michael Grant, which all of you know is my absolute favorite science fiction book series. And this series had me on the edge of my seat until the very end. I did not want to sleep before finishing the book, so I was walking around my bedroom with the book in my hands just so I could stay awake for a little while longer to finish the book. And I did, and then I fell asleep, and then I dreamed about the Quarantine series. Another thing that I really like about the book is David's humanity. I mean, during the bloodbath, David could have killed Sam, but he chose to spare him. I know Sam wouldn't have done that. I also really liked how the reader can see Sam's descent into madness. I mean, he wanted to kill Will and Lucy, but he was stopped by, did you really think I was going to give that huge spoiler away? No. What did I dislike about the book? I didn't necessarily enjoy the love triangle between the brothers and a girl. the creepy meter kind of went upward by that, and it was just not my cup of tea in that regard. And then I also hated how brutal Hillary was to everyone. Cheating on David and having no remorse. Shaving a girl's hair off and having no remorse. Deciding Brad has a right to Lucy's body and doesn't care if Lucy gets hurt, and she still has no remorse over that. And then being the dark reason behind Sam's decisions in killing David and still having no remorse. There are a whole lot of other reasons, but I'm not going to get into that. And then there was one other thing that I also liked but didn't like. And the book ended with a cliffhanger. And I'm someone who can love and or hate those. I have other books in the series, so this won't kill me wholly, but I still don't necessarily like the cliffhanger ending just because there are so many strings that need to be tied up or woven together or however the phrase goes. However, moving on to the ratings. Amazon rates the book 4.6 out of 5 stars. Barnes & Noble rates the book 4.2 out of 5 stars. Goodreads rates the book 3.9 out of 5 stars. Google users says that 93% of readers enjoyed the book, and my rating, 5 out of 5 stars. There are several reviews, but I'm only going to talk about 3 of them. Booklist reviewed the book as the best high-concept young adult thriller of the year, a paranoia-soaked novel in which an infected Colorado high school is quarantined by the government and leading to various cliques that transform into warring tribes, gritty and fearless. I have to say that I agree with that as well. Then Publishers Weekly reviews the book as a high-concept mashup, tossing Walter Hill's The Warriors into a high school setting and seeding it with elements of Lord of the Flies. And Voya reviews the book as quarantine thrives on themes of human nature and an unrealistic tone. Unpredictable, gory, full of death and despair, this story is not for the lighthearted. And Huffington Post Books reviews the book as you will not be able to put this book down. And considering I read it in 5 days, I would have to say that I was not able to put the book down either, because every single time I was doing something else, eating, sleeping, writing, all I wanted to do was read the book. And I really enjoyed it. I highly recommend it. And as far as final notes go, because of COVID-19, I think this book is the perfect one to read under quarantine. Wouldn't you agree? And as a final note, tell me in the comments below what clique you think you would be in if you were in the quarantine series. I have a feeling I would either be a nerd because I love books, or I would be a loner who hoards books in a secret classroom place, whatever. Anyway, that is all for today, so if you enjoyed this video, hit that like button to show some support, subscribe to my BookTube channel to get more videos like this, turn those notifications on to be notified when I have a brand new video uploaded, keep on reading, and have a great day, everyone!